Hi, this is Connie from PowerPoint Design.1. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create stunning paintbrush effect from PNG vectors in PowerPoint. First, you need to open a blank presentation, and then you need the Inkscape app installed on your computer. If you don't have it already, you can go to inkscape.org. You find the link in my description. And then you install it on your computer. Go back to your presentation. Now you need some images. And I find mine on onlygfx.com. And I have found some pretty amazing paintbrush strokes here. I copy the picture. I don't download it. I just right click and copy, and then I paste it into my presentation. Then I press CTRL+X to clip the image. I open my Inkscape. It looks like this. And I paste my image, and then I choose path and trace bitmap. And I have to change this number from 450 to 990. And then you have to make sure that this live preview is selected. Press OK and close. Now there's actually two layers of the same image here. Select the top layer and drag it to the left. And then you press CTRL+X, paste it into your presentation, and then you have to ungroup it. It's very important. When you ungroup the image, it becomes a shape. It's converted to a shape, and now you can actually change its colors. You can add effects, and you can also add images. I think I'm going to pick one more. So I find one here. No, I think I go to pixabay.com, because you can actually find these vector PNG vectors several places online. I think I'm going to use this one. It's very important that you choose vectors with transparent backgrounds. So I just copy this, and then I go to my presentation and I paste it, resize it a bit, CTRL+X, and then I go to and I paste the image. And because I didn't close Inkscape before, the number is still 990. And the live preview is selected as well. So I click OK and close, drag it to the left, and then I press CTRL+X. Then I paste it into my presentation and I ungroup it like this. Now you can change the color and you can fill it with a picture. I think I'm trying to this one. It's pretty dark. And I send the photo to the back and select the shape and intersect. Now you have this pretty silhouette filled with an image. Actually, I have made a presentation with different kind of paintbrush strokes, numbers, and I have also some ink splash. I have letters, I have circles, and I found these footprints, which I find is very funny. I don't know if I'm going to use it, but then I have some social media also, and then the image of the woman. Now, I don't have to download images from online every time I need to use it in a presentation. I just open this one and then I can copy from this. Well, I have also copied some in this into this presentation, and I'll show you how to use it. I copy these and paste them into this slide, and I'm going to combine them. Just resize it a bit, and I think I'm going to make it like this. Then I select both and go to merge shapes, and then I'm going to click on union. Now it's one shape. Then I'm going to pick a photo. I have a collection of my own here, and I think I'm going to choose this one. And then I paste it into the slide, send it to back, can resize it a bit. Now this photo is selected, and then you select the shape, and then you go to merge shapes and click on intersect. And now you have this paintbrush effect, photo effect. You can add some shadow. I'm going to show you with these circles too. Do this. Resize it a bit. I think this will do. Select both. Go to union. And then I find another photo. I think I'm going to pick this one. Copy and paste. Send to back. Going to resize it. So, and then the photo is selected, and now I'm going to select the shape and choose intersect. And then you can make it brighter. And you can also add some shadow effect. This is the end of part one of how to create paintbrush effect in PowerPoint from PNG vectors. In the next video, part two, I'm going to show you how to create the paintbrush effect from fonts. See you next time.